So today's going to be the beginning of a three-part series on Google Flights. Now, the reason I've chosen Google Flights is it is the number one place to go to get all of your flights. It has the best pricing that 99% of the time. Every once in a while, there's something better someplace else. But honestly, this is our number one go-to place for our agency. And so you get the best prices. You also get the best information. It brings the most information to you into one place. So it makes it very simple. They also have the most tools to be able to tweak and change so that you're absolutely confident that you're getting the best price available. So without further ado, let's dive in. Really quick before we jump into it, I've been getting a question a lot lately, and it's something that I'm often asked over my 20 years of working in this industry, and that is, with so many travel websites available today, how in the heck do I know which one to go to that's gonna really give me the best price, that's gonna actually give me information I can trust, that I can actually rely on? So, what I've done is we've put together a free resource to help answer that question. So we've culled through all of the travel websites available today. We found the ones that give you the best pricing, that give you reliable information most of the time, but the best pricing most of the time. And we put together a cheat sheet, a travel planning cheat sheet. So it tells you exactly who to go to for what, depending on what it is. It tells you what order to go in so that you can plan the most spectacular vacation possible. It helps you save time, it helps you save hundreds, if not thousands of dollars, and it helps save stress when you're on your vacation because it covers all the little details. So if you'd like your copy, you can download it for free in the link below. Okay, enough of that. Let's go ahead and get back into it. So today is day number one, and today we're just going to do a brief overview of how to use Google Flights. Now this is going to be without all the bells and whistles and tools. This is just a very simple step-by-step how to use it for anybody who's never used it before. So if you just want a very simplistic way to book a flight quick and easily, and that's what we're talking about today. So let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, so this is the Google Flights homepage, and it's very, very simple from most things that I'm sure you've used in the past when you have booked your own flights. I'm gonna go through and just do a very simple overview first, and then I'll go through and teach you all of the tips and tricks to tweak your results and get a better result and make sure and feel confident that you're getting the absolute best rates available. So for our purposes, let's go ahead and say we're gonna go from Los Angeles. And let's say we want to go to Paris. Okay, and I'm going to say, let's say I've already done my exploration and my inspiration, and I already know the dates I want to go are in January. We're going to go January 22nd through the 29th. For our purposes, I'm just going to say it's one passenger because it'll make it a little bit easier to understand the pricing and compare the pricing. But up here is where you would put in whether it was one-way multi-city. And multi-city is if you wanted to say start in Paris and then fly to Rome, and then fly home from there. That would be multi-city. So you would put this here instead, and then you would simply add in the next stop after that. For our purposes, I want to keep it simple. We're just going to say a simple round trip fare, simple economy, but you can also say if you wanted to upgrade it to business or first class. We're going to keep it all simple just for this initial run through. Okay, so let's go ahead and click search and see what we find. See, Google Flights is very fast. I love that. When I've used Skyscanner and Momondo and a bunch of other places, it could take 60 seconds or 90 seconds sometimes or longer to bring you all of the options. I don't understand why they take so slow or why they're so slow, but it's kind of annoying. Google Flights is super fast, and that's part of the reason that I love them so much. Okay, so once you do this initial search, what it does is it gives you the top prices available. It also gives you, things like how long the flight is, how many stops there are, what airlines are available for that flight. If you keep scrolling, you get more options, and then it's usually sorted by cheapest to most expensive as you're looking through. And what you would do from here is say you just simply wanted the cheapest and you were okay with two stops and you were okay with it being 20 hours. And it looks like you over here, you would start it on JetBlue and then you would switch over to Air Portugal. Say that was what you wanted and that was fine. You would simply click this down arrow here
It would give you just some more details about times, what type of airplane it is, which will matter, and we'll talk about that in another video, whether or not there's any overnight. It gives you all of these details. Okay, if this sounds great, you simply say select flight. Now it takes you to that was your outgoing flight. This is your returning flight. So it gives you all of your returning flight options. So you can choose from there. If you want to keep it at that cheapest price, you would need to pick one of these two. But if you didn't like the time of these, or maybe this time here, your leaving time, say you wanted to leave Portugal a little later in the morning, you could pick this flight instead, but just to know that it will raise your price. So it clearly gives this to you. Let's just say we want to keep it cheap and not have any problems. Like for instance, here it has this little warning because there is an overnight layover. So you will have to stay overnight somewhere. Whereas this one, there's no warning sign. So let's go ahead and choose this one. And I look through it. I'm like, yep, that's fine. I say select flight. And then this gives me my flights that I chose. It looks like the total price is going to be from $521. I get one free carry-on bag. And also I can check a bag for free. And it looks like it's a no refunds situation. And then down here it says booking options. And it tells you all of the places to go to book it. Now, a note on booking options, and it looks like there's even 9 others, and it shows you where you can book and who has the cheapest. So for instance, down here with Orbitz, you see it's more expensive, $542, $542. Down here, even Cheapo Air is more expensive. But then if you come up here, it looks like GoToGate is the cheapest that you can book it at. A note on booking engines. When possible, try to book it directly with the airline if possible, or through a third party if you have to, but hopefully a third party that is reputable, that you trust. So for instance, an Expedia, an Orbitz, a Priceline, a Kayak. Oh, well, Kayak is different. I would feel better booking with one of those than something I've never heard of before. I've heard of them because I've been in the industry a long time, but Flight Hub, Just Fly, I'm not as familiar with them, so I wouldn't necessarily feel as confident booking with them. They're the most expensive in this scenario anyway, so I wouldn't. But the reason being, I would want to book directly with a airline or with the airline directly, because if something happens, if I need to cancel, change a flight, something like COVID happens again, I want to go directly to the horse's mouth, so to speak. I want to be able to contact them directly and have them take care of me. If I'm going through a third party, Expedia, Kayak, something else, you know, Cheapo Air, Priceline, whatever, I have to go through them and they have to go through the airline in order to get a refund or to make changes. And to me, it feels like it muddies the waters too much and it makes it more complicated and it creates delays, and I really don't like it. So if I can book directly on the airline and get the same price or a cheap price, I will do that every single time. Now, if it's just simply the third party is just a lot cheaper and it's better, go ahead and book with the third party. But when you can, I try to book directly with the source. Now, if you don't see the airline listed as one of your options, I always go to the airline just in case to check what their rates are directly on their website. I just want to make sure that if it's possible to book and still get the same price on the airline, I would rather do that than a third party. That's kind of the gist of what I'm trying to explain in a very long, drawn out method. Okay. So if this was the flight we were booking, I would simply say I wanted to use GoToGate. I would simply say select. It takes me to that booking engine, that separate booking engine. And then I would simply complete my booking on this website. All right. That is the simplistic, easy way to go through it. So we're sitting at a price of $521. Let's just keep that in mind. So that is the first day where we're just covering all of the basic flow of how to use Google Flights. Stay tuned for the next series, which will be coming up in a couple days, where we're gonna start going over all of the tools and tricks that you need to be able to bring that price down and to find better flights. In the meantime, if you'd like to learn more about how to find the absolute cheapest prices every single time, go ahead and take a look at this video here. And if you enjoy
enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up and share and hit that subscribe button if you'd like to. And I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.